Hello guys, Tune here back again. This time we're going to do Ghost Sweeper Mikami on the Super Famicom. This is a game based on a manga that came out in a weekly magazine, and then they made a TV series, made an anime of it, and then in 1993 they made the Snes game, or Super Famicom game. As far as I know, this only came out in Japan. This is an action platformer. So, we'll start this up. The first thing you want to do, guys, is go into the options and change it to stereo. For some reason, it puts it in mono. So we'll start this game up. So you get these little anime sort of things, but we're going to skip this at the beginning because I can't understand them. So guys, you play Mikami, who's quite a big sprite as you can see. She can attack, she can down attack, and if you hold up on the pad, she does an overhead attack, which pretty much hits everything. So that's the attack you want to be doing most of the time in this game. There's no slide, she just basically jumps and attacks. So basically you scroll from left to right in pretty much all the levels, and you attack ghosts with your stick, or sweep ghosts as I said. If you jump and hold down the button, you grab onto ledges and then she does like a little attack as she jumps up. I say this game was developed by Natsumi, who's made some really cool games. It's a pretty fun game. It's got some, it plays alright, the playability is fine on you. I do have a problem with the shoot 'em up, well, the shooting sort of level, which I think plays goddamn awful. But we'll see if we get to that now. Yeah, you just basically fight your way through the levels. Most levels have got two levels and then a boss. So when you first play this game, the bosses can be a little bit tricky, but they're not too bad. What you can also do is pick up power-ups for your sweeping stick. Only problem, if you get hit, you lose those power-ups. There's three different ones. There's like a wide wave attack power-up. There's like a lightning power-up, and there's a two-way attack. They're very useful, and I'm playing awful. They're very useful, they're very good. You also got a special weapon, which is one over there. That one sucks in enemies, and the other one you get sort of pauses enemies in position. Some bosses can be paused in position, which is very useful for getting multiple hits on the bosses while they can't move. So, we'll carry on. Got reasonably quite good at sort of speeding through the levels on this. Now we end up on a train. As you can see, the graphics are not bad. They're not fantastic. I suppose they're very, they want to go for like an anime look, maybe not overly detailed, but they're good enough for what they are. Some of the backgrounds can be a little bit crappy. There's one background like on a waterfall which looks a bit crappy, to be honest. It's really blocky and a bit shitty, but apart from that, it does the job, the graphics. I say this game came out in the Super Famicom, and it used to be a reasonable price, but these days this game is going for well over 100 quid, which is ridiculous because it's not worth well over 100 quid, but that's retro for these days. The only problem with retro these days, I think eBay have hiked the prices up. I think what it is say if you want 50 quid for a game on eBay, you have to sell it for 65, 67 quid or whatever to pay your eBay fees these days. So if someone buys that game then, which somebody wants 50 quid, but they're selling it for 65, somebody buys it, and then all of a sudden completing listings then is 65 quid. So people go on there and put those games back up on there, quid. But then have to pay their eBay fees and everything again. So next thing you know, somebody's put that game up there for 80 quid. And I think that's how the prices have got hiked up. So we'll carry on. Playing a bit stupid, but I'm trying to rush through the levels. I suppose that's more fun. Then to the first boss. So this boss is like a ghost thing that comes out of the walls. I have stun locked him once or twice for about 8 or 9 hits. I'm not entirely sure how you do it. Like that. Timing that is. The boss dead anyway. For some reason my headset turns off, I don't know why, maybe because there's no audio volumes. So I'll feed the volume back to myself. Right, anyway, you've got a Castlevania-esque sort of end of levels. With the crystal coming down. So you basically complete the levels and you fill in parts of that statue. And then basically there's six levels you fill in the platform, on the statue, sorry. And then there's a seventh level, which is like a jumping sort of platformy level with some weird gravity going on, which I'm not overly fussed on, to be honest. And then you get a last boss, which is your eighth level, which is not a level, it's more of just a boss basically. So we will carry on going. Right, so this is a water level. So that water does push you back. Weapons are quite useful on the water level. Go. So you could speed through this level then. Right. There is actually a secret down here. With an extra life. For some reason you get these letters in game. I've found two of them. I don't know whether they're significant to anything or they do anything, I have no idea. I haven't found anything they do, but I found two of them, a G and an S. Don't know whether they add to like a, I don't know, add up to a secret or something, I don't know. Or maybe they're just nothing. It's a bit weird to have a letter down a hole. No reason at all. This weapon comes in very useful for this level, as you may have noticed. I tried jumping down the other holes to see if there's anything, but no, it's just you die basically. Get my fish before I jump up here. A little sort of magician lord bit with the frogs jumping down a little bit. So this game does remind me of the Valis games. I am a bit of a fan of the Valis games, I gotta admit, but I'll have to do a video on them at some point. They were a set of games made by Telner Japan. I think the third one and possibly the first one got a release outside Japan, but I do like those games. This is that level with the really sort of blocky, crappy water background. Handy with this weapon. I'm gonna jump over. Oh no! There's Engie over there. Probably don't need it, but may as well get it since I'm here. Here we go. You can see where the weapons come in very handy. Especially this double one. This double one's really useful. Thank you. going. This is the Doll Boss. Doll Boss is reasonably easy to... Well, I don't know, it could be a little bit tricky at first, but the idea is these hands come down and attack you. But what you want to do is go for the one hand and keep an eye out for where the other hand sort of pauses, like that. And then the hands attack you. So if you keep attacking the one hand, that hand won't actually do the attack on you. It takes a little while to kill it, but I wouldn't even... it's going downhill fast. Keep a little bit more proper attention to what I'm doing here. That's the one hand dead, so it's usually reasonably easy enough to kill the other one. You don't get mobbed by little doll things flying you around. Chucking a few more dolls at me now. Cool, that's the doll boss dead. Little Castlevania bit again. If I don't know if you noticed, she changes dress colour on each level. I don't know exactly why, maybe it's just a, you know, an aesthetic thing, but I don't think it makes any difference. I've actually got a grey dress on now. Maybe they're like different days or something. Now you get the strange level when you jump onto a giant cat and scare it and it runs off. This level's got a few little tricky places where getting hit is really easy, and I'm going to use my super weapon to actually get through those bits soon. Swallows, they attack you straight away. Pull that one. Right, one of those bits is coming up soon. Do worth out getting it, like if you're lucky enough, but I'm not going to risk it. I want to try and get full energy for this boss coming up. This boss is a pain in the ass. That's cool. Full energy for the boss. I hate this boss. He can trap you quite easily. See, the weapons actually don't actually attack it. You wanted boss to do that. See what I mean about this boss being a pain in the ass? Oh, I do hate this boss. Fleas are a pain in the ass. die again then. I found that boss really annoying at times. Ideally, you want to get him to do the like the pipe attack on him, because he's basically vulnerable the entire time. That statue's getting filled out now. That was pretty good. It's got some pretty nice music. Damn. When I first played this level, it was quite tricky. There's another one of those letters up there. Ideally, you want to be at the top of the level because it's a bit easier. Platform attack, but you know, that's not good. Sometimes hit that tomato strawberry type thing. So now in this one, you've got a... Oh, damn, you want to go quite quick through this level, so those things that fall down then miss you. What happens if you don't get through the level quick enough. Coming and attacking you, that's the only thing. I should have done that. Wasting lives now. So there's a little bit of variety in the levels, which is pretty cool. This is where you want to gather through fast luck, and you miss a lot of those things falling down. Trying to do it too fast though. Like a dog. See if I can get to the boss of this level. This game is pretty good fun. Oh damn, I don't wonder why. That's what happens if you attack that woman there. The dog spirit boss now. Sometimes I can do this without getting it, sometimes I can't. You can catch him sometimes on the way back, like that. Like that, you get a nice double hit on him. Visually, sometimes with the two dogs flying around, when you can hit the one's leg zooms off. If you stay up in here, you can just duck down. Yep, that's it. He's not too bad in his home. Guys, next to the shoot 'em up or the shmup type stage, which I hate this stage. It's a real spoiler on this game, this stage. It plays terrible. It's got loads of momentum to the actual controls, and the controls are really slow and sluggish, and it's very, very hard to dodge out of the way of anything. So there's a one level of hate in this. This level could have actually been really cool if they'd given you proper shoot 'em up controls. This level could have been pretty good. Just trying to go back there, it's almost impossible. Go forward, you just can't move backwards. No control over it at all then. Fighting the boss is tricky. He spins all over the screen, and it's just so hard to hit him. So hard to just dodge out the way of anything. Magic just the end of it, because I got no lives left, so. Magic's not. It is useful on the boss, but he checks out loads of bats. Now, here we go, I'll see if I can actually do this. He just attacks you and just very, very, you've just got to move and hope you're not in the actual way of him. Like, there's no way of dodging him basically when he does that. I do, I had to stop myself getting hit then. Dead. Anyway guys, that is Ghost Sweeper Mikami on the Super Famicom. It's a pretty good fun game, I quite like it. I've played it quite a bit over the last week. I really do hate that shoot 'em up level. It's terrible, that shoot 'em up level is. And I probably would have gone with maybe a 7.5 or an 8 out of 10 for this. It is quite good fun, but I'm going to knock it down because our shoot 'em up level is so bad, and I'm going to give it a 7. It's a fun game. It's worth a go. So if you've got an EverDrive or you've got to play on an emulator, play on a Raspberry Pi, whatever, you know, pick it up, give it a go, see what you think of it. It's pretty good fun to play, but I wouldn't suggest original cartridge because it's just not worth the money. But yeah, apart from that, it's a pretty good fun game, so I'd give it a 7 out of 10. So guys, I'll catch you next time. See if we can do... I don't know what I'm going to do next time, we'll see. Maybe I'll do some Vanus games or something. So I'll catch you later, guys. Thanks for watching. Ta-da!